In a previous video, I showed you how to export the Word document as a PDF using Print to PDF or Save as PDF. But which option is better? In this video, I'll compare both methods so you can decide which one works best for your needs. First up are the document properties and tags. In the Word document, I've populated the document properties with a title, and the author field automatically contains my name since I created this document. When I now open the document properties of the printed PDF, you can see that all of this information is missing. Additionally, this document doesn't contain any accessibility tags. If I check the other document for these characteristics, it already looks much better. The PDF does contain all the properties and also the accessibility tags. Note that the Save as PDF method allows you to choose whether or not you want to keep all that information in the exported PDF, so this method is definitely more flexible. Next up is the file size. While the printed PDF has a size of 326 kilobytes, the saved document has 78 kilobytes. And the Save As option not only creates a smaller document, it also gives me more flexibility again since I can choose to optimize the size of the PDF. This reduces the file size by another 13% in this example. Then let's look at interactive content. While some people think that links will lose their functionality in printed PDFs, this isn't actually true. A printed PDF as well as a saved PDF will both have interactive links, so there is not really a difference between the two. Another interesting topic are images. Even if images look sharp in Word, they typically get blurry in an exported PDF. I explained this in more detail in another video, but you can circumvent the quality loss by using a proper scalable image format like SVG instead of a PNG, as Word will not compress SVGs when exporting the document to a PDF. Of course, this solution doesn't work for photographs, as you can't really convert a photograph to an SVG, but it does work for digital sketches or illustrations. So let's compare the non-scalable PNGs first in both documents. As you can see, in the printed PDF, the edges look a bit smoother. This can give the overall impression that the images in the printed PDF look better. However, these smoother edges are created by the rendering engine introducing intermediate colors that aren't actually in the original photograph. So, while the edges can look smoother, they can also contain visual artifacts such as color fringing or blurring, which can affect the accuracy of the design. Now let's look at the scalable SVGs. The SVG in the printed PDF doesn't really look any sharper than the PNG since the printing option converts the SVG into a rasterized image. When we look at the saved PDF, you can see that I can zoom in as much as I want and it will always stay sharp since the Save As method preserves the SVG as a vector graphic. In conclusion, this means that if you have a lot of scalable graphic files in your Word document, you definitely want to go with the Save As option. But if you mostly have photographs, you might want to try the printing option to see if the images look better with that option. Another thing we have to compare is the compatibility of fonts. As far as I know, the Print to PDF option doesn't have any issues with modern font files. For the Save as PDF option, you need to know that the engine behind this function has problems processing variable font files. I won't go into too much detail here since I created a separate video for this, but just in case you work with fonts from Google Fonts a lot and you notice the fonts looking different in the exported PDF, you might want to take a look at the detailed video. I'll put a link in the video description below. And the last thing I want to make you aware of is the paper size. The Microsoft PDF printer ignores the paper size you set in Word and defaults to the size in your system's printer settings. This can be frustrating if you frequently switch between page sizes. I again made a detailed video about that, which you will find in the video description below. The Save as PDF function doesn't have any problem with different paper sizes. And that's the comparison between Print to PDF and Save as PDF. If you care about document properties, file size, or using scalable graphics a lot, or frequently working on documents with different page sizes, then the Save As option is often the better choice. But if you're dealing with photographs or variable fonts, Print to PDF might work better for you. Personally, I prefer the Save As option, but what about you? Let me know in the comments which method you use and if I missed any important differences. If this video solved your problem, then you could do me a huge favor by subscribing to the channel and also liking the video. Thanks a lot, and I see you in the next one.